Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this episode, I'll be answering the question, how did Buddhism spread to Thailand? When we talk about Buddhism, one of the countries that pop up in our mind might be this. The S shape is a distinct characteristic of Thailand's map. Well, besides beaches, food, boxing, and people's smile, Buddhism is another important thing in this country that impresses a lot of tourists around the world to come visit Thailand every year. Believe it or not, Buddhism has been the major belief in Thailand for more than 1,000 years. According to the National Statistical Office of Thailand, almost 94% of Thailand's population is Buddhist. It is the third largest Buddhist population in the world after China and Japan. But how did Buddhism spread from India to Thailand? When did it happen? And who did all of the tasks? Before we look closely to the history of Buddhism in Thailand, we should start from the origin of Buddhism first. Buddhism was founded in India by the Buddha around 4th to 5th century BCE. After his enlightenment, he traveled around northern Indian regions and taught people for about 45 years before he passed away. About 250 years BCE, the great Indian Emperor Ashoka of Maurya Empire started patronizing Buddhism. In his efforts to propagate Buddhism, he built many shrines and monasteries around India. According to ancient Sri Lankan chronicles, he sent Buddhist missionaries to distant regions such as Kashmir, Gandhara, Sri Lanka, Yuna or the Land of Greeks, and Suvarnabhumi or Southeast Asia. Some believe that the missionary monks who went to Southeast Asia started their mission in the Nakhon Pathom province, where a giant stupa is situated. This might be the earliest date of the introduction of Buddhism in Thailand. Well, actually, there was no Thailand yet until 1,000 years later. Anyways, from 5th century to 13th century CE, most of empires in Southeast Asia followed Mahayana Buddhism, which was influenced directly from India. It started from the south and spread to the north of this region. When Sukhothai, the first kingdom of Thailand, became a powerful state in this region in 13th century, King Ramkhamhaeng asked senior monks from Sri Lanka to come to teach people in his kingdom. These monks brought Theravada Buddhism to this region for the first time, and this was the beginning of Lankavamsa, or the monastic lineage of Sri Lanka in Thailand. Since then, Theravada Buddhism thrived in Thailand and some other countries in Southeast Asia, such as Myanmar, Cambodia, and Laos. During Ayutthaya period from 14th century to 18th century, all Thai kings and people supported Buddhist monks and monasteries. They built temples, statues, wrote stories, dramas, and poems that were originally inspired by Buddhism. This tradition has also been followed by kings and people of Thailand in Ratanakosin period. Even though it's been more than 2 millennia since the Buddha passed away, Buddhism still influences Thai people in many aspects, such as architecture, culture, lifestyle, and even their language. Talking about language, it's time for my favorite thing ever, language explained. Today's language explained is the history of Thai greeting word sawaddee, which is equal to hello in English. This word literally means, may the wellness be with you. It was borrowed from Sanskrit and Pali, the two main languages of Buddhism. It was coined by Phraya Ubakisilapasan and was declared to be the national greeting word in 1943. This word can be used to say both hello and goodbye. Quite convenient, right? So, if you want to know more about anything, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you in the next episode. สวัสดีครับ